Come to the region of life. Is somebody hearing me here tonight? There are people who are alive, but they are not alive. You didn't hear me. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There are people alive, but they are not alive. Why? They are not behaving like a person that is living. The Bible tells me of a person that have 38 years sickness. If somebody used 38 years to service sickness, is that life? Are you hearing what I'm saying? 38 years. And he's using that. That's not his age. That's the age of his sickness. Hey! Praise God! Are you hearing me? So even if you are alive, but you are living as if you are dead, because you are more in the region of death than in the region of life. Tonight, there will be a transfer. 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 In the name of Jesus. Such that when they get to that former region, they won't find you there again. Hallelujah. 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 When Jesus said to the young man and say, arise, he had in the realm of the spirit. May you hear from your spirit tonight. Don't hear from your senses. Your brain will tell you you cannot walk. Your brain will tell you you cannot see. Your brain will tell you you cannot hear. Your brain will tell you your hand is not working well. Your brain will tell you your leg cannot move well. But if you can hear the voice of the spirit, and the voice of the spirit says, arise! Praise God! You won't know when you jump up. Praise God! You won't know how you jump up. Hey, is somebody hearing me tonight? Is somebody hearing me tonight? Very soon we begin to pray. And everybody will be praying. Be serious with your own prayer. Don't look at somebody else. You didn't come here to come and look at people. You came to see God and God to see you. And tonight, God will visit you as an individual. The visitation of God will be individual. Individualistic. Hey. Praise God. A dead person hear God. From the region of the dead. He had God. Wherever you are, wherever your spirit is tonight, wherever you are hearing the sound of my voice tonight, you will hear in the spirit realm. And you will rise from your problem. You will rise from your situation. You will rise from your infirmity. You will rise from your demonic hold. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When you hear right, you will behave right. But if you are hearing it in another way, you just be saying to somebody, why is he shouting? He should know that I cannot walk now. Can't you see my leg? Can't you see my hand? He should know I cannot walk now. No! Hear correctly. Hear the word of the Lord. I am not the one that say rise up. God is the one that say rise up. And if God say rise up, you will rise up. If God says see with your eyes, you will see. If God say walk with your leg, you will walk. Tonight, you will rise. 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 In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And then he delivered him to his mother. The miracle all the while is because of that mother. God was concerned about that mother. The problem that this woman has gone through is too much. Losing the husband, now losing the only son. This problem is too much for this woman.
That's why Jesus was so concerned and said, whether you invite me or you don't invite me, I will stop this devil in your life. And he entered into the life of the woman so as to wipe out the tears. In this case, what Jesus did to wipe out the tears was to bring a dead child back to life. Hallelujah. It may be something else you need to wipe your own tears. It may not be a dead child. It may be a dead job. It may be a dead connection. It may be a dead relationship. It may be a dead covenant. It may be a dead arrangement. Whatever used to make your life joyful, but the devil has closed it up and stop it. If God can open it again, where you have closed the case, if God can open it again, he has opened your joy. Hallelujah. 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 Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? For more than 17 years, Jacob was in sorrow because of Joseph, his son. The boy left the house around the age of 17. And then the brothers came and said, he has died. And they gave evidence. Are you the owner? Do you know who owns this clothes? It's coat of many colors. This is the one you sold for your son Joseph. But we find it somewhere. And blood all over it. So we perceive it's very likely to be your son's clothes. Where? What about the son? We can't find him. Maybe the animal that killed him and left only the cloth with some, with the blood. So that's just what we want to give you. So this is the cloth. Hey, praise God. Now this man has lost the wife who is the mother of Joseph. Now he's losing the son. Double sorrow. So from that day onwards, though Jacob was alive, it's as if he has died. Because the only source of joy has been removed. So what can happen? Years upon years, things begin to happen. And then to cut the story short, one day, those same brothers of Joseph, they came back home. They said they came from Egypt, where they have gone to buy food. They have found out that the man they are buying food from is not an Egyptian. He's an Israelite. And not only an Israelite, he's their brother. Your son, sir. The one we told you died that time. The one we gave you the clothes. And we told you that he has died. He's not dead though. He's alive. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Not only that, he can't believe that kind of story because he knows these people always lie. I can't believe them. They say, follow us outside. And when he got outside, look at that vehicle. That's Egypt 002. Number. This is number 2% in Egypt. You see that wagon? It is a return ticket to Israel. I mean to Egypt. So he said, when we are bringing you, we should bring you with your wife, with all your children, and with all your family, and everything you have. So that thing will take us back to them. He wants you to come and see him. The rest of your life, you will no more use in poverty. You will use abroad with your son, who has been abroad long time.
But you thought your son has died. But God brought a dead person back to life. Stand up tonight. Praise God! Praise the Lord! Where they thought it has ended, when they thought it has come to an end, but God said it has not ended. Even the child that they think has died, but God can bring life out of the dead. Hallelujah. Why? He wants to remove your tears. He wants to say, weep no more. Whatever he can do to bring you back from death to life, he's ready to do tonight. 7 days is the program. Tonight is the first night. Tonight is the first night. And I said to you, your miracle is going to be a testimony to other people. Because you came the first day, so you received the first miracle. The woman that Jesus met in the city of Nain, she was the first person to receive the miracle, so that she can go back to the village. Hallelujah! Excuse me, sir. When somebody have people following her, and they are going to bury her ground, and people are giving them drum, but it's not the kind of drum you dance to. This is the one you cry to. That's the one they were singing around her. And suddenly, before they get to the burial ground, where they will drop the child, they met Jesus. Jesus stopped the procession. And when Jesus entered the procession and made the dead child to become a living child, so they did not enter into burial ground. Hey! Praise God! So they turn. You will turn. They turn. They turn. They turn. And they kept going home. They are still singing. The drummer that was drumming before is still drumming. The people with the trumpet, they are still blowing. But they changed their song. Praise God! Praise the Lord! Your song will change tonight. 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 Those who used to see you and they mock you, those who see you and they shake their head, those who see you and they say, the devil has really battered this woman, they will come again. When you return back, after you have met Jesus, and they were returning home, hallelujah, they were not singing the song of mourning. Hey! They started singing dancing songs. He has changed their mourning to dancing. Is somebody hearing me tonight? God will change your mourning to dancing. God will change your weeping to singing. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Is somebody hearing me tonight? That's why we want to pray now. We have about 2 or 3 levels of prayer. I don't want us to waste time. Tomorrow you come early. So we start early and finish early. Because this program is not only for Arigidi people. People are coming from different places. Hallelujah. And I want them to get back to their on time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Who's going to help me to sing there? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said because of love, he will change the law. Jesus fell.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Eshelomu yakpawa.
Hallelujah. Ole baba se fell.
Hey!
Bolorun laja. Kole roju rere ra.
O ofe o
suma la ro
ore o le suma
ofe ore o ese lo mu ya pa wa dagbere fese
o le mo bo ti fe o
bola ro la ja ko le re ju re re
suma
Ore ko le suma
O fero le
E se lo mu ya pa wa
Dagbere fese
Ko le mo bo ti fe
Olorun laja
Ko le reju re re ra
Suma Shalabari gede gede ya bada gada bada ya gada da ye de ye de gede bodo bo ya gede gede
Uru ya pawa
Ikele kedo de ya
wa Dagbe restesha Ole ma boti fa Ola run laja Kole oju re re la
Suma
Suma la ru Ore ole suma O fẹran rẹ o ẹṣẹ
o mu ya pa wa
dagbere fẹṣẹ ko le mo bo ti fẹ o Ọlọrun laja ko le oju re re la
suma
suma Ọlọrun o ọrẹ ko le suma o fẹran rẹ o ẹṣẹ lo mu ya pa wa
Tonight, you are there and you are hearing what we have been saying since. Only one thing can stop you from receiving your miracle. That is sin. Whether small or big, one sin will not allow somebody to make heaven. And if you gain anything in this world and lose your soul, that's a great loss. Everything in this world, wealth, property, materials, whatever, cannot equate your soul. The soul of a man is more important to God than all the property of the world. So tonight is a night of decision. You want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You want to say, Jesus, come into my life. Take sin away from my life. Give me a new beginning. I want to walk with you. I want to follow you. I want to become a member of your family. I don't want to continue in sin. If I keep sinning and I die in sin, I can't get to heaven. But if you can deliver me and give me a new beginning and give me the power over sin, then I follow you. I will serve you all the days of my life. If that is your prayer, but you don't know how to go about it, you just come forward tonight. I'm going to pray for you in a special way. Or on the other hand, it's not that you have not come to church before. You've been going to church, but you don't have power over sin. Sin is still having power over you. You just do things that you know you ought not to do. If you know that you are a Christian, you know Christians shouldn't sin. They should not be smoking. They should not be drinking. They should not be carrying women around. They should not be sleeping with anything they find on skirts. You know it, but you can't stop it. That means that sin is stronger than you. But if you can come to Jesus tonight, there is a stronger power here tonight that is able to deliver you. And once you are delivered, there will be a new beginning. And then you will run the rest of your life victorious Christian. Whatever is your level, don't let this call go for nothing. respond to the call of God. Why we take that song one more time? Everybody that wants to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior, you don't just raise up your hand, you come and meet me here. And you have to run because I have a limited time. Now that song one more time. Hallelujah. So I'm waiting for you. You are saying, Jesus, I want to accept you as my life and Savior. Come over to me here. Just come over and wait for me. God bless you. Clap for them. Come on. I'm waiting for you. That's why we're here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before I pray for you, there are still some of the people there. I'll give you 2-3 examples. I already write them down here. There is somebody that is there. You sleep around more than normal. You sleep with women more than normal. Whether small, little girls or married women. You don't have limits. But your problem came when you slept with a little girl that is demonic. You don't know that that lady has taken your semen to the spirit realm. Since that day, you can't help yourself. Tonight, God wants to deliver you. There is another person there. You are a lady also. The first one is a man, this one is a woman. Now, almost like that other one, but you are the one having the power to take any man you want. Anybody you want. You know what to do to get them. You have been given that power in the realm of the spirit. But tonight, if you come and join us, the anointing will break that demonic hold and you become free. As another young man, now what is causing your own problem is that you watch pornography internet, and that is already making you to become a problem to yourself. First it was like a habit of fun, now it's a spirit. So you need deliverance. So you have to come and join them tonight. So I'm going to count 1 to 10. Anybody that know that you should be part of these people, but you are still sitting down there, maybe you think we are playing. I don't come to Arigidi to play. God is here. Yes. The power of God is here. Amen. What you have cry about, you can't have a solution. God want to give you a solution now. So I will count 1 to 10. If you know you are there, or even if you are not in the field, you are hearing me from afar, but you know this is the hour to make a decision for God. I'd like you to join them. Don't sing again. Don't sing. I will just count 1 to 10. By the time I finish counting 10, and you are not out, it means you are not part. 1. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. 2. I'm just waiting for you. After the count of 10, you know you are supposed to be there, but you are still lingering. I won't further delay. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7. If you are coming, run. 8. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. 9. Thank you, Jesus. You get to a point in life that you want to, you tell the devil, no more. That's 9. Before I finish praying for them, if you are part of them, make sure you join them. Place your hand on your chest. I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus. Now say the following words after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you tonight. I want to accept you as my Lord and Savior. Give me a new beginning. Rub my name from the book of sinners. Give me the power of go and sin no more. And write my name in the book of life. Make me your child. I don't want to go back to my sins. Give me the power to live above sin. Thank you, Father. The Bible says, if I come to you, you will save me. You will not cast me out. You will rather take me in. Tonight, take me in and write my name in your book of life. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Every power that has bind you hitherto, I bind that power in the name of Jesus. Every spirit supervising your life with different kinds of afflictions and different kinds of iniquity and sin, I break that hold in the name of Jesus. Every hold of Satan over your soul, I break them in the name of Jesus. Whosoever the Son shall make free shall be free indeed. Be free in the name of Jesus. Free in the name of Jesus. Free in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Still place your hand on your chest. And raise one hand up. Father, any sickness in their body, small, big, medium, I command. The Bible says, you spirit of sickness and disease, you will hear me and you will fade away from your hiding places. I command you now. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of sickness and disease, I command you, get out in the name of Jesus. I say, get out in the name of Jesus. I say, get out in the name of Jesus. And let the spirit of life in Christ Jesus dominate you now. Amen. From the top of your head to the sole of your feet. Amen. Be healed. 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 Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Give Jesus a clap offering, somebody. Hallelujah. 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 Please, where are they going to? That side? Now, please, can you go to that direction? Keep clapping for them. See that, madam? Okay. Keep clapping, please. Clap for them. Clap for them. Mommy, let people get there after writing their name. Minister Holy Ghost baptism to them now, not tomorrow. Everybody getting born again. All those brothers that came from Akure, follow them there and minister Holy Ghost baptism tonight, not tomorrow. No time tomorrow. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm only hearing this side. Are you tired? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now we said this program is Arigidi Healing Crusade. Now, if there is any sickness in your body, that sickness has made a mistake tonight.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Whatever the sickness may be, small or big, we want to pray now. You have any sickness in your body, a condition you don't want again. Now I want you to come and meet me here. I'm going to pray for you now. That's why we say it is healing program. Whatever the sickness and the disease, the presence of the Lord is here. We have not just come to clap hands. You cannot come the same and go the same. There is a difference. Supernatural power of God is here. The Bible said that Jesus Christ came to teach them and he preached to them. But the power of the Lord was present to heal them. The power of the Lord is here tonight to heal you. Hallelujah. 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 Praise God. Are you with me? Are you with me? Now, raise one hand up. I want to be praying for you now. But before I pray for you, I don't know which sickness you came for. I want you to talk yourself. Use your mouth to talk to God. God is here. God is here. God is here. The manifest presence of God is here. And that presence of God is to tell you something. That he has come to heal you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So I want to give you 2 minutes. Open your mouth and talk to God. This is what I want God to do for me tonight. This is what I'm requesting from God tonight. Is it your eyes? Is it your leg? Is it your ears? Is it your back? Is it your baby? Is it your child? Is it your husband? Is it yourself? Is it your son? Talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. Open your mouth. Talk to God. He can hear you. He's here. He came because of you. Rusha kabaraka tu rebele kodo shaliada ande keri barayede. Membra la kazote de korima sedeyata. Rico parete le perina masenderian koriba sheya. Robare ketelina na senderian to korabaya. Thank you, Jesus. Ebra lo sokotori mare de yakos yedekerosi ala perina magado shala karuda yadagai. Holy Spirit, thank you Lord, thank you Lord, thank you Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the story we had today, Jesus Christ told a man that has died. He said, arise, take up your bed. And a dead boy heard God. And he rose up. After the prayer today, you will hear a command. Whatever you could not do before, you start doing it now. Don't say, but I can't do it. That is before. But now, that your former condition will change tonight. If it is your eyes, place your hand on the eye when I'm praying. If it's the ear, place your hand on the ear when I'm praying. If it's your leg, touch that leg when I'm praying. And after the prayer, drop everything, begin to walk. Let everybody leave you, begin to walk. Open your eyes, you begin to see. You open your ears, you begin to hear. You open your mouth, you begin to talk. Whatsoever you cannot do before, you can't carry your leg, you carry it. After the prayer, because God is here, and you'll be going around to touch people in different areas of their life. Father, in the name of Jesus, every spirit of sickness, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of disease, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of blindness, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of deafness, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of lameness, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Every bone problem, I command you be restored. Every back problem, be restored. Every backache, be restored. Every hand and leg, be restored. Every eyes and hand, be restored. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Drop everything off. Begin to move. You couldn't move before. Begin to move. You couldn't walk before. Begin to walk. You couldn't talk before. Open your mouth and sing. You couldn't hear before. Open your ears and hear. You couldn't see before. Open your eyes and see. In the name of Jesus. Jesus is already here. Jesus is already here. Jesus is already here. Take space. Take space. Let somebody give you chance to be able to exercise yourself. A dead man, rise up. A dead man, rise up. You will walk by yourself. You will move by yourself. You will hear by yourself. You will bend yourself. You will bend your head. You will bend your head. You will move your hand. You will bend your waist. In the name of Jesus. Jesus is already here. Oh, come and begin to worship him. Something is happening in the house. 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 Give Jesus a wave offering for everyone. Just wave him, wave him, wave him, wave him. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Do what you couldn't do before. Begin to express yourself. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Thank you, Father. Tomorrow we take testimony.
Amen.
Tomorrow we take your testimony.
Amen.
Tomorrow we take your testimony. You will have seen the hand of God. In the name of Jesus. You will have seen the hand of God. In a mighty way. In the name of Jesus. Give Jesus Christ a clap up for somebody. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Please have your seat.